models a face so that there's a presence there. It lives. It's not a picture of a person, and it's not the person itself. It's something in between. He gets to something behind the face. First of all, the vivacity of Ray's touch. He can bring to life a picture by modeling it in paint. I mean, you know, the paint sits on the surface of that glass. The glass refuses to absorb it and keeps the paint entirely on the surface so that it's almost a low relief. And that requires Ray to model the paint itself into a presence.
His work has always been about invention and primarily paint. But in these in particular, I felt like this is what he was meant to do. And I think it showed in the work. I think it's his application of paint. I think Ray is so in love with the paint itself. And so the abstraction is a byproduct, I think, of his infatuation with the paint. He's become so facile, making just the right mark and just where it needs to be.
That's a group of work with which I'm particularly taken, in part because of the conceptual thrust of the project itself. In part because of the new approach to painting that Ray is undertaking in it. And finally, because of the not simply superior but impressive technical chops that Ray demonstrates in portrait after portrait.
Ray has always been a moving target, and that's what I think is why his work is so vital, because he is constantly moving and restless.
He's already demonstrated superior powers of concentration, and now he's demonstrating remarkable powers of improvisation, and the combination is virtuosic.